Hey, what's going on? Hey, so I'm still trying to mess around with chords. I don't know if I've made too much headway, but I'll show you what I've been working on. Basically, right now I'm only able to do them in the top end of my falsetto range. So for me singing like the B's and C's and stuff, that is like I can't go much higher and it still have much of a tone. So you understand my voice type. I'm kind of doing the Do, go, go, go. And that's my normal, like, talking, main singing range. Go, 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 go. So that C and just above it is about the highest I can go. So only in that top part of my range. And I'm guessing that my estimate on how I'm doing this is that I can tell, my guess right now is that I can tell that there's some sort of mechanical switch happening between normal falsetto and between almost like a whistly falsetto. I don't think that this is the same thing as the whistle tones that you'll hear in like pop singers like Mariah Carey. It's not that kind of whistle. It's just, I don't know. I just don't have another word to describe it. But if I'm singing a loud or a wide falsetto, like if I'm singing that, it's pretty full, like full vowel. As I bring the vowel back into an ooh, I'll actually feel a hum, like a turn in the sound. And I'll do it slow and see if I can show you. Let's take it on an A. So you actually hear like this. Down, like it's like this little flip thing that happens, right? Right? And so it's partly vowel dependent. And so I think in messing around with the vowels in that middle area, I think that the two tones may be coming out of me like barely being able to get those two different mechanics to happen at the same time, like a weird kind of crossover. And so far, like the vowel of what I'm doing is really important. It doesn't really work. I can't just like sing the notes. Like I have to find like a vowel placement for it. And the only reason that I don't think that this is overtone singing, because it's not, is because overtone and normal throat singing, everything moves in parallel. So the problem is that you have a pattern of overtones, and as the bottom note moves or as your root moves, the everything would waver on top of that. Now you'll hear my falsetto wavering, but you'll also hear the notes distinctly kind of go not quite the same direction. And so especially the third one, the one that's on the bottom. And so also overtone series has pretty big jumps between the root note and between the upper partials. And so I'm not going to be getting a third above a root with overtone singing. If I was doing overtone singing, it'd be like like those kind of overtone singing, but those overtones, you know, very separated from the root. With this one, I'm singing a note and I'm getting the immediate third above it and a note below it. So I'll show you what I mean. So, and I'm also trying to work with intervals between the top note and everything else. So I know I'm dragging on, and I'm just trying to voice my thoughts on it as I'm going, because talking helps me try to figure it out. So here's the B. Now, if I were to do that and bring in the vowel, I can pinch the back of my throat. It's not actually, I'm actually keeping a lot of space in the back. Like I'm keeping like you can see that everything's actually dropping a little bit to get these, but I feel like it's dropping to create the space, and I'm squeezing a little bit up top, and I can feel the extra pieces vibrating in my throat, in the top of my throat. And so I'm gonna see if I can do just a range of notes on this, if I can. So that's the B. So if I try for B and D sharp, right? So that's the major third, and I'm going to see if I can do the minor third. And see, I'm having trouble. I'm kind of sticking in that major third thing. Let's see if I can do it more full. It helps me sometimes. I don't know. So you can hear it kind of going in between the major and minor. Not quite. All right, so if I take that, so if, even if I'm just doing majors, there's B. Then there's D flat. Three-noter, right? If I keep taking it down, it kind of gets tougher. So hopefully you can hear that third tone underneath. Kind of slip and slide, but whatever. So that's those are my experiments right now. I like doing lots of weird vocal stuff, and actually right now my voice is kind of tired because I've been doing this a bunch the past couple days trying to figure it out. But yeah, hope this helps for those y'all trying to check it out. The cool thing is if you check out Layla Hathaway doing this, which notably, like, as I'm listening to singers, I can't find any other singers that do this kind of polyphonic singing, like not frequently, like maybe by accent, maybe, but I don't know. So before people say tube and throat singing and this kind of throat singing, this kind of overtone, like when you listen to those singers and the actual pitches that they're getting and the textures of their voice and the mechanical work that they're having to do with vowel shape and everything else and range of where the notes are actually placed, like Layla Hathaway's is totally different, right? And so she's getting these close-knit voicings of what she's doing, and she's able to move them a little bit, as to where normal throat singing, you have a bass note, and then you have overtones that move very, very pattern-based above that. And so, I don't know, so check out hers if you want to hear, like, a really good recorded texture of somebody doing it really well. And until then, I hope you enjoy messing around with it as much as I am, and it's fun. Don't wear your voice out, because just like learning throat singing or anything else, like no, like that kind of, this isn't very comfortable to do yet, like that's not a completely natural thing, and so I'm still trying to get used to it and figure out if it's if it plays into my vocal health that well, but for now it's fun and it's a cool party trick, and so hopefully I can throw it into a song or something, it'd be neat, and so good luck, let's keep it on.